I have this big bat boy right here because I love Sacrifice so much.
I mean, this just destroys them, right? So we're gonna get two Sacrifice triggers, which brings the whole board away.
Snatch it. Here I go. Got my Deadly Dispute now.
I can see what they're doing. I can see it. I feel it. It's cooking.
So this is gonna get us two triggers. We're bringing Runarch Vet, Innkeeper, and Face. Talking me through Sacrifice lines, you'll be teaching the Pope how to pray. What's up and welcome everyone to a new video. And in this video, we are going to be playing Explorer. So today it's time to treat myself by playing my absolute favorite deck and archetype of all time, Rakdos Sacrifice, to prepare for the upcoming Explorer Qualifier that can qualify you for the Arena Championship. So if you're not familiar with Rakdos Sacrifice, this deck revolves around three cards. Cauldron Familiar and Witch's Oven, who work together perfectly since you can sacrifice a cat to the oven, create a food token when you do that, and then you can sacrifice a food token to bring back the cat, and do it all over again when a Witch's Oven untaps. Now while you do this, you sacrifice permanents, and that's where key card number 3, Mayhem Devil, comes in play. Because Mayhem Devil deals 1 damage to any target when you sacrifice a permanent. Now this deck is great against midrange decks like Rakdos Midrange and really good at controlling decks with a lot of creatures once you have the holy trinity of Cat, Elf, and Devil on the board. Now this deck is quite difficult to play and involves a lot of thinking ahead and doing the math because you can get lethal out of absolutely nowhere with this deck. Now I've had games where I've dealt 90 damage in one turn, which was just awesome. And every game with this deck feels like solving a little puzzle, and it just scratches that itch for me. I genuinely think Rakdos Sacrifice is a perfect Magic deck. Now this deck qualified me for my first Pro Tour back in the day, and I actually ended up making Day 2 with this deck as well. I love playing it so much, and the people that have been around on the channel for a while know me for playing Sacrifice rather than Cookies, so huge shout out to those veterans, I appreciate you guys so much. And who knows, hopefully I can go back to that again at some point, but it does mean that Explorer has to turn into Pioneer completely, because I don't see Explorer ever getting more players if that doesn't happen. At the moment, it's just better to play Pioneer on MTGO than knock off Pioneer on MTG Arena, and I think that's one of the main reasons why Explorer barely has any players nowadays, unfortunately. Now hopefully, by the time Wotzi puts the entirety of Pioneer on Arena, which is scheduled at the end of 2024, the player base will increase again, because the Pioneer meta is in a pretty great spot with a lot of versatile decklists and archetypes. So here's to hoping that Wotzi stops slacking on Explorer and gives it the love that it deserves. Now let me know in the comments if you still play Explorer and what your thoughts are on the format, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Now let's get back to my roots by playing some Kettleven.
This video is brought to you by Ultimate Guard. Ultimate Guard provides you with premium protection for your trading cards, ranging from sleeves, deck boxes, playmats, binders, and more. Ultimate Guard has everything you need to keep your Magic cards safe, secure, and stylish. Support the channel and yourself by purchasing your Ultimate Guard products using the link in the description.
I'm not gonna keep that though, are you kidding me? Easy, yeah, Fable will fix it. Fable will fix it, surely, surely. Surely. Alright, so... I'm trying out some Sacrifice right now because it's my all-time favorite deck, it's my best deck, and I wanna see what's up. So... yes. I think we're playing against Boros, so they will have access to Gleeful demos. That could be pretty rough on my Cauldron. Let's see though. Why the an Ornithopter? Slay. That's all I can say. Slay. Okay. Probably snatching that Warden up, I think. But I can also try to set up a really good turn with Harvester and Devil. But then it wouldn't ping away the Warden, so... it's gonna be greedy and grab this. Especially now that I have my Oven available before they Gleeful it. Yeah, yeah, there's like the standard version of the deck is available too, right? Doesn't play Ornithopter though, a little Thopter that could, but... yeah. Oh, not my Witch's Oven. Interesting. Huh. They might just play Recruiter here. Nope, not yet. Giant killers. I think they mainboard that. Nah, the standard version is pretty good. I like the standard version too. Ooh, this person is in fucking trouble. This person is in trouble. All right, you guys ready for this sick fucking play? So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna discard the Cauldron Familiar, get a Mayhem Devil trigger, remove Thalia, get rid of the whatever happens there. We have the Claim the Firstborn. I'm just trying to figure out if I want to use that or not, though. Like, do I need to go that extreme? I guess I could get rid of the Giant Killer, but I can always get rid of the Giant Killer. We just killed our board, as a matter of fact. We have one, two, we got like three pings. Five damage, three pings, so that's removing all these 1/1s. Yeah, I don't think you lose here anymore. But okay. You don't lose here anymore. I'm just trying to figure out if... what's the plan? Got five damage to the face, and next turn I have it again. I'm just thinking about if I ping away to 1/1s to try and, like, hold their Loxodons off. Probably. No, it's true. It's true. Like, we do love a good sacrifice moment. I don't know if this is, like, too respectful. But... I think if I give them no creatures, they will never be able to win, so... we'll see. Yeah, so I'm playing like this version that some pros are playing. We have two meat hooks in the main in this deck, which is pretty spicy. This is solid enough. I mean, the pain lands fucking hurt. Playing Death Shadow over here. You love... I love Sacrifice, I mean, obviously, like... you know, there might not be besties aware, so like, let me actually fire off a thought season, look at their hand first before I flex on you all. But that is a bunch of Loxodons, but if I hit that, Resolute Reinforcements, they're gonna struggle, I think. So I'll do that. Yeah, I'm gonna grab the Ornithopter because if they have Lethal Demo, the Loxodons work again, so I'm gonna get rid of that. Anyways, yeah, not to flex on you guys, but like, I'm gonna hit this intermission screen. Oh wow, it actually worked. Obviously, some of you might not be aware, but like, I have this big bad boy right here because I love Sacrifice so much. So a little bit of lore for my newer people. It's been a while since I've played Rakdos Sacrifice on stream, but yeah. Big Rakdos Sacrifice enjoyer. I got that boy in like 2019. It's a space invader, yeah. When am I getting that covered up with Simic? Yeah. Simic to two up next, y'all. It's true, it's true. Okay, I fear we cannot get rid of these Loxodons. They hit the Resolute off the top. Okay. Tough cookie to two when? Yeah. Low-key, a tough cookie on my thigh if I can, if I qualify for, the Pro Tour playing cookies, I'll put a tough cookie on my thigh. But I'd have to go to the RC first, and the RC has to shove me in the PT, and then I'll put a tough cookie on there. Promise. Tough cookie tats in Chicago. Yeah. Goes hard as fuck. Okay, so... Phoenix Chick. Now, Phoenix Chick hasn't given me the same amount of luck, I'm afraid. Alright, I can remove Resolute Reinforcements, and then I can get rid of Warden of the Inner Sky. Thoughtseize doesn't hit Loxodon, unfortunately. They had some good top decks that truly kind of fucked me up a little bit, I'm afraid. I can just do this then. Clip it, ship it. Okay. Yeah, no, I'm serious. If the cookies lent me into the Pro Tour again, then I'll be I will fully. Oh my god, can you stop just hitting all the cards on top, Chief? Oh my god, unreal. Unreal. Yeah, no, okay. You're not welcome anymore here. Fortunately, we have Kiki to get rid of that stuff. Yikes. Good draws from the opponent. Well, maybe my strategy was too ambitious. It could be true. It could be true. Let's find out what we're gonna do here. I could double block Warden of the Inner Sky. I would take, what, 12? I have two pain lines on black. That doesn't seem like it's going to work out for me. We could chump Venerated Loxodon, take 9. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out, like, what is the way to win. I am not sure. I think I'll try like this. Okay, we have a Fatal Push. Two lands. Absolutely not bestie. Chatter the Kiki. Ooh, shit. Ooh, okay. That's probably the best draws we could have ever had, I think. Okay, I'm gonna need all the mana I can get. Start by pinging away to Warden, I think. Okay. Bessie just stopped back till the very last second, didn't they? A nightmare. A nightmare for real. Rude. Yeah, a little. A little. Trying to figure out what I want to do here, because I have technically two more pings. I could shove Devil in front of the big Luxodon. I have to put two pings there. I'm probably better off just keeping the treasure, to be honest, and just putting a ping here. I'm gonna go in about it like this. Staying alive, staying alive. Goodbye, Devil. You did so much work for us. We are grateful forever. It's true, it's true. All right. I think the best strategy here is to hold up 2 mana. Because we might want to heal. Okay, I can swing with this guy though. Yes, I could have, but I mean, Imidane does the same trick, right? So. And I am working with like two pain lands here, so I'm valuing like keeping these treasures around so I don't have to die to my own shit. Yeah, I could have done token. I could have done token, like food token treasure, but then you're also kind of like off sync and you have to sacrifice a goblin shaman to get your cat back online, to get your food token and like keep the chains going. Yeah, we're just gonna try to win this game with Harvester Copies, basically. That's the plan. Okay, I kind of whiffed on that. Love that for us. Zek is so fucking tricky to play in paper too, like, oh my god. There we go. People always say, oh, it's easier to play on Arena, because, but hell no, it's absolutely not. It's easy to play in paper, I'm like, hell no, it's absolutely not. There's just so many triggers to keep track of, it's insane. So many tokens. Another harvester has arrived. We got two harvesters over here. That would reach the Loxodon, because I guess we could get enough food for blood tokens, so I'm probably gonna keep that. I kind of need like three mana up. I don't want to use any pain lands. I'm wondering if this is too greedy. I feel like it could definitely be because I might have to tap Kiki too. I can just do one, I guess. I'm just trying to avoid using these. These will be used for me to pop a food token if I need to. Like, wait. Normally it doesn't actively try to kill you, but I guess it is now. I don't know why you're acting up like this, though. Holding up two mana here. Okay. Trying not to die. Nah, it's true, Sarkin. Like, what the fuck's going on right now? Like, normally auto-tapper does whatever it takes to, like, avoid tapping a pain land, and now you want me to take two? You're crazy. Stay alert. Stay alert. Don't give up. Anyways, got out of that one. But this is arguably, like, one of Sacrifice's best matchups, I would say, so... Yeah, you'd only really lose the Convoke, usually. I'm already in. We had the top 250 finish, fortunately. This is a good hand, and it's another Rakdos mid-range gamer. It appears to be one. Started with Thoughtseize. Let's have a look. Banky B? Banky B? Banky B? Alright. Are they playing Bank Buster because they don't have Copter? I know, like, back in the day they used to play Bank Buster in a deck, but... Right, so I'm going to put my own Harvester in play here first to get myself a blood token, and then I can grab their Harvester and use it to my advantage. We'll see if they play into that, though. Okay. Thank you. Fable? Energy? Oh. I've gone back to Bankbuster from Copter. Interesting. Interesting. Banky B still going strong, I guess? It's a good thoughtsies. That is a good thoughtsies. Okay. No. Was this? Oh, I was thinking Bone Crusher. They paid a two? Okay, the fuck? To discard Harvester? Yeah, throwing their life total away like it's timeless. It's true. For what? I have discard on Sokasan to get Fatal Push, remove the Trespasser, but I'll see. Seems like the jury's still out. I see. Nothing? All right. Snatch it. Discard. Get rid of Sokinson. Got my Deadly Dispute now. Here I go. That's crazy. They paid the two and then eventually, like, just did not get rid of the Harvester, like, but yeah, or you do, I guess. Life is a resource. Silly. Okay. That's a main board K command. That's fine, I guess. Full control in Arena always makes me like fucking panic a little bit though. It's like I'm always afraid to like just click through things. Mm. I'll play the two here to hold a push. I have Den of the Bugbear to attack it with as well coming up. Can always discard the cat. I think we have some stuff here. Okay. I guess we don't. The rest in the main and K command in the main. Nah, this person just cooked too hard. Like, they just cooked too hard. I don't know what else to say. They cooked too hard. Overcooked, yeah. And sting it with Den. It's about to say, like, you better work here. Steal five. Opponent wishing they didn't. They were at five life right now rather than three. Silly. Okay. They still mainboard children in these stacks, right? God, I need to really keep up with the Pioneer meta again. Yeah, well, that's fine. Game trying to sabotage me. Yeah, it's a star, please. Indy's a star. Banky B. Bankibi. Should probably put in a braid too. It's a good one. Ugh, if only. Could you imagine Cookies having access to Bankibi? Spicy as fuck. That would be spicy. Bankibi was too cracked. Rip. Cookies and Explorer. I'm thinking about it. I don't know if I'm like ever like, you know, if I'm ever bored enough. It's definitely up there with things to try. Let me just put it that way. I'm open to the idea. I'm open to the idea. I think it's something cheesy that could work in Pyo, but I don't know. You have some good cards too. Yeah, you got Ensel Artifact and shit. You got Hardened Skills. Could maybe cook with that a little bit too. I don't know. There is cooking potential. Be a real treat. It's true. All right, I want to guarantee myself a land drop and yeah, some other treats perhaps. Good. Witch Oven, Cauldron Familiar, Druid Girly. Like, I mean, I might like. I'm really tempted. Like, I'm really tempted. I'm really tempted. I think I'll just play the swamp out. I can like remove the graveyard gluten and take the discard to my advantage and shove a cat in the graveyard. That's a plan. I can also just play cat right now and just like chill. Vintage high ash 4x stuff cookie. I hate that that's true. Like, I do. I hate that that's true. I hate that that's true. I'll play it out, fuck it. Not really too scared here. Instant speed interaction for Amalia. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. It's probably gotta be something better in there, isn't there? Ooh, you're gonna snatch my hook? Okay. That kind of sucks. Okay. Sure. The cat can block, yeah, gag. What the fuck is this sorcery, you know? Crazy. Is not doing a fantastic job piloting RB mid, I feel. But okay. Not really like many things in a graveyard for them to be working with. Okay, what happens if I Cauldron Familiar? Bring him to 9. Hook my own board. Bring him to 6. Close, but no. I'm just thinking, like, am I gonna be greedy to the point that I'll just play Hook out regularly? I guess so. Like, I don't think I lose here. I don't know. I don't know what they could have, like, sideboard-wise, like, techs and stuff, but... I doubt it's much. Shelly, sure. Let's have a look. New oven. Spicy. Like, all right, we'll take it. They made some interesting plays. 36 though, we on the way, y'all. Sheesh.
This is not bad. We got the dispute. No cyberbullying. What does that mean? Not now, sweetie. Mommy is cyberbullying.
Oh.
Okay, so potential first Malia gamer spotted. Immediate Amalia slam. Right, so this is where we gotta be a little careful, huh? So we kind of want to save our deadly dispute for a claim to firstborn. I think our best bet is to just thoughtseize here. Shit. That is a good hand. But yeah, obviously we gotta hit the walker, right? Because then we just have it. It's like... solid hand. Nah, it's true. Alright, we're gonna grab Amalia here. This Thoughtseize could not be more clutch. Beta 3, yes please. Swing with both in case they're silly to trade with Lunark Vet, which they're not. Dispute Amalia. And we're just gonna have to seize that Coco away. So, okay, so now to be careful, because return to ranks is what, 3 white, right? 2 white? Mm, 2 white, I think, which they don't have just yet. Two white and X. Okay, so like X is 3. Oh, it's got Convoke. Right. Alright, well, we gotta set ourselves up for our best self. Like, we could go hard removing this Lunark Vet, but I think if they... like, I could go hard in removing that, but there's so much more value in, like, just slamming Fable. I could see if I can put fear in him by, like, tapping like this, maybe? All right, I didn't have it. Thank God. Yeah, I'm like a bluffing push. But yeah, this is huge. So I want to keep the push. This hand's perfect. So let me swing with both. So I think on our end step, we're gonna be sacking and pinging. Unlucky witness on the end step sticks around till the next turn, which is nice. Ping that away. And the treasure allows us to hold a push still as well in case shit goes wrong. Okay. Yo, Popo, thank you for the 5. Thank you, Burr. Better land here. I mean, this just destroys them, right? So we're gonna get 2 sacrifice triggers, which pings the whole board away. There you go. Should have sequenced that differently, but it doesn't matter. I think we just have lethal here either way. I mean, it's actually like a lot of ways to get lethal. I was gonna get silly with it, like, either way. Anyway, I was gonna get silly with it, create a third devil, and the third devil sacrifice will deal 3 damage, so. That is a lot of life gain. Alright, I'm just gonna hold up Deadly Dispute here. I go Dispute now and try to see if I can find Thoughtseize. I don't hate that. Nothing there, I fear. Roiling Vortex needs to be activated, so no use slamming that here. This could be an Nexus 2 port and it could just be over already, you know? Just yet. So I could try to set up Ashok here, but she's not very safe. So let's do Roiling Vortex. Auto Shepherd tried it, I called it. Trying to be as focused as I can get. Whenever an opponent casts a spell in return, my Voice of Resurgence dies, create it. Okay. I mean, this could go wrong, but I'm gonna try. Well, Voice is very, very much claim the first and claim like a card that we can hit with Claim the Firstborn, right? Like very much so. Okay. Start off the Fable. Need Hook. Yeah, remember that one person that was like, Hook's useless. Now, I think Hook can be hit or miss. I don't mind. We're kind of just looking for like a claim to Firstborn or some shit like that. Ice Cube, thank you for the 10. Appreciate you. Get Elven, Devil, stuff like that, yeah. So this is an okay trade. I do still have my push around. They do have Selfless Savior, though. But I think that's an okay trade. They protect it, fine, then the dog is gone. Got ourselves a devil. Got ourselves two devils. Just gotta be careful though. So I don't hate the idea of casting Deadly Dispute here. You would sack the treasure, get a new treasure. Think both Lunark Vets. Obviously doing it on our opponent's turn is not ideal. Not really useful to play Ashok out because then you can build a vortex. Okay, this person in their turn, time them out. Go ahead and time out. Thank you, Cass. So that doesn't even work. We don't want to grow the Voice of Resurgence. That's a claim. We don't have a sec outlet right now, and then we just pass a turn. I think we probably just allow this for now. I need to find an oven at some point. or it's gonna turn into trench warfare. So let's handle that. Yeah, I think we played extra safe here. I think this is just where we're gonna slam Ashlizzlle to stop the cords. We're just gonna minus to get rid of that Lunark Vet. And then hopefully we are able to get rid of everything the opponent does. Get rid of their whole board and hopefully find an oven at some point. Start swinging. I have this still. I have this still. So if they're gonna try to get funny with us, we are protected. Just trying to figure out how I want to go about things. So I put Harvester in play. Yes. So this is gonna get us two triggers. So we bring Lunark Vet, Innkeeper, and Face. It's fine, I guess. I can go ahead and like use your food, you know, I don't know. Okay. Fine. I'd say, like, are you sure? Are you sure? Alright, so now I'm thinking, is lethal possible here? It could very well be. Oh, I forgot about that thing. It's fine either way. I don't think it matters, but I need to remove that real quick. Let me hold on a second. Hold on a second. Can I not respond with? Okay, I guess I can do respond into here. Floating red. So that's gonna remove Gilded Goose, and then the three pings are gonna remove, probably gonna go to the face. Two to the face, three to the face, push the walker, swing for like nine, have it die, still have this. Anyway, yeah.
Ooh, is that a Kelvin in our opening hand?
Maybe. All right. Interesting. Well, we're definitely going to lead with a swamp here, but then it's just deciding. So what are we up against? We see a recruitment officer here. That's probably going to be white weenies. I think you fire off a Thoughtseize here, see if you can get that, see if you can get a Thalia's recruitment. Future of Planeswalkers, don't have to worry about that one. We have two lieutenants here. I can grab one lieutenant and then deal with the other. Thalia also exists, of course, which isn't great. She would make the whole hand a bit more expensive. Which I also am not a fan of. But I could also hit Thalia, so with Fatal Push, I guess. Yeah, I mean, it depends. Depends on the way to develop, because, like, a cat can obviously block that, like, a cat can obviously block that little like, 2-1, so. We're probably gonna fire off on Thalia. Alright. The Golgari deck? Nice. Alright, we're just gonna like remove Thalia here. That's gotta be like Mutavault activation. Alright, then we gotta set up some Kelvins. Let's play this banger. Let's go get some good vibes. All right, let's start gaining some life. Okay. Another push, yeah, that's probably gonna eat Lieutenant, even though Bitch with Horse, like, also is a problem, right, Adeline? So I'll have to be a little bit strategic about it. Brutal Thar, okay, that's kind of like throwing away a creature there. So, okay, we're just gonna have to be a little bit strategic here because Recruitment Officer does draw a bunch of cards, right? This thing grows, but eventually I'm gonna have double Kettleven set up. So I'm thinking the right card to get rid of is gonna be Recruitment Officer. And I think we do it now before they start drawing cards. Thanks for the hype chain, y'all. I think we're just gonna remove that. And let's develop another Kelvin. So now we have two cats and two ovens, so we're booking two creatures a turn, which is great. Okay. Hype emote looks pissed. It looks a little goofy, like, I don't know, it's like a pissed disco ball, it's like truly an experience. Alright, I found the new recruitment officer. Alright, let's get this set up. Okay, so we're gonna just do our little sacrifices. Go. Take two. Kill two. gonna have a look at drawing some cards here. Just do a Druid Deadly Dispute. Wouldn't mind a Mayhem Devil or something. Ooh, that's a hook. We kinda just need to find like a way to do like an X's 2 hook, I think. That's pretty solid. Alright, we're just gonna pass the turn in. Okay. I think we still have to pop village rights for whatever it's worth, because I think we might want to find a way to access 3, especially if Qatar flips, which it might. Depending on what they have. We'll see though. Okay, they're actually going for recruitment officer activation. That's okay. But it does mean that Qatar flips to 3. So we're gonna have to, I think village rights the Cauldron Familiar. And look for a land. Let's block the highest creature. Sacrifice the cat. Take 2. Adeline, a bitch with a horse. Yeah, this is a 22 land deck, so we should have a decent chance and like a land in the next 3 draws. I hope. So. But we'll do it now so that I think. Alright, so unfortunately, we whiffed her. We don't have an Nexus 3. No, this is not ideal, because the other problem that you're facing now is like, you don't have Catwoman active. So this is quite a problem, actually, because we don't have a cat, something to sacrifice. Like, I don't have this active anymore. I was really banking on the land here. And we flopped, so I guess we're gonna set up double harvester here. Which isn't great, but it's gonna put my Catwoman back online. So Qatar flips. Now the question is, do I allow this to go through? I think I do, because I can get it back with Devil. Yeah, see, they have this play now, and then they followed it up with Ossification. We also gotta, like, remind ourselves we have a lot of power in here, right? That's, like, 6 power into Witch Oven. Yeah, so Ossification lands on Harvester, and we're just gonna do that to that. Opponent will swing with everything. Yeah, missing that land drop was quite painful, but yeah, we're setting up the Devil now. That's not bad. So yeah, what do we have here? We have 5 damage plus an additional 3 damage. So we're like 2 off from lethal, I fear. Anyway, you're gonna have to set up Devil here. Sunset Brew, thank you for the 3 months. Appreciate you so much. Thank you, thank you. Okay, so the vibe will be to, I mean, you can remove the Brutal Cathar. You can just do that right now because I do know that they have those protection spells. You'll see in like the white weenie deck. So let's remove the recruitment officer as well. There we go. Yeah, for any oven activation with not a food around goes for 3, so we still have that going for us now if we want to throw that to the phase, and then we still have like blood tokens to sacrifice as well. It kind of just relies on like, does the Mayhem Devil live? It's a big part of it. Now, I hope they don't have what I think they might have, because that would suck. Is that actually a... Oh, really? Okay. But I think we're still okay. Unless they have another. Because Adeline gets lowered in power, so. They kind of fucked up not attacking with the Mutavault. Yeah, they fucked up not swinging with Mutavault. Alright. No, but would they not just have an attacker though? I don't know. Oh, and they had this too? Nah, they fucked up royally. Nah, they fucked up big time. They had all that too? Oh wow. Interesting. I mean, what we can do is like, we can just do like this. Yeah, they threw. They missed Adeline's lowering of power. Because they basically had like the perfect hand to like get out of that situation, right? So they didn't count life from Cat, yeah. I don't have mana open to like remove something of my end as well. No, it's already lethal. You don't need to backseat. Trust me, like if there's any deck you don't have to backseat on, it's Reckless Sacrifice. I can promise you that. Even though, like, I am slightly rusty. I have about, like, 300 more games than what the average Twitch person would have on Sacrifice. If not more. It's like teaching the Pope how to pray. So we got a push and a collapse. That's pretty good. This is showing potential. I know, right? Like, that's a lot for me. That's a lot for me, right? Alright, so they start off with a Dauntless Bodyguard. I could put a cat down and try to trade with it. It does make cat vulnerable to like exile stuff like portable holes. I do have a Molten Collapse at some point to unlock that portable hole, which is pretty good. They could also be firing off a what's it called? Lieutenant. So then the trade doesn't really work, and I'd rather push the Lieutenant already. But playing cat now also sets up Deadly Dispute, so I think I'm gonna risk putting cat in play. I mean, if they ossification my cat, like, I guess so. Yeah, sure. Yeah, I have Rakdos Second Pioneer. On paper. Pioneer, Rakdos Sacrifice on paper. There you go. She can't talk. Alrighty. I think we might as well play this out on black. This is sorcery speed. But obviously, that's not the target right now. Nah, like, I've just played it so much on paper now. Like, I've finally gotten to the point of, like, not missing triggers. And the token piles, I just put a die on it. So this is a very easily, like, mayhem devilable target. So I'm just gonna take it. And, you know, push whatever else they'll put in play. Which could be like Athalia or something. Or, yeah. So I can try and curve into Kiki. So this is a nice grab, or could be a nice grab. They could actually sacrifice in response. So it's not the best grab, but it's doable. I'm gonna set up Fable. Because Fable could create treasures, and treasures could ping with the devil, so that's good. It's the energy we like. This is game one, so I don't know. I'm ready for him, though. I have, like, five heavy graveyard hate cards. 3 Leyline of the Voids, and, 3 Leyline of the Voids, and, like, 2 copies of, Ashok. My sideboard is heavily decked against blue-white control, Amalia, and this hand's perfect. Anything else? I'm heavily decked against blue-white control, Amalia, and Phoenix. So, as much as I can get. Alright, so let's claim Adeline. I think so. I think I am in a position to swing with both. Get myself the treasure for the devil so we can set up being the bodyguard. Get it reasonable swing. We'll then dispute Adeline. We might hit a land. No? That's okay. We have pushes active and we have a really nice hook here too, so that's good. We're gonna be passing our turn. Yes. Soon to have a Kikijiki flipping. We see a Mutavault swinging. Now that seems worthy of a Fatal Push to me. A little bit of land destruction. There we go. You can have that one. This is going to be bodyguards protecting bodyguards. Which does not make for a bad access one. I can obviously set Devil up too, but I really quite like the Excess one here. I remove my own creature, but it stays alive and gives me a treasure, so I'm gonna go access one. There's not much they can do about it. It's, you know, minus minus effects. Swing. Then we're just gonna hold. Like, it's not worth pulling two treasures for Devil when that could literally remove two creatures, so... Agree to hook ban on standard. No, because no out of pure self-interest. I would like to see hook back still, you know? Alright, so ossification hits reflection of Kiki Jiki. That's fine. That is another Devil. Alright, how much damage do we have here? If I put this in play, then I ping them for 2, they go to 7. And then I ping them for 2, they go to 5. So that's not there. It could still be just worth doing based on the fact that, like, you know, we'd have another 3-3 deck and swing in. So I think it's worth it for that reason. Even though we miss out like on some big value, you just try to like win with creatures, right? So let's see. I wish Fable was still in standard too. We could be playing Anvil and shit. The dream. Okay, so here we have Portable Hole that hits this one. I guess I could have hit hook too, couldn't I? Huh. Either way. That is a pretty good setup, even though the castle look twain is a little awkward. Okay. So we're not seeing any companions, we're seeing a mole. These four MGO people don't know what they're dealing with. Yeah, they don't know. They don't know that we're in the 14 and 2 trenches over here, like... Okay, so I'm just trying to figure out, because that castle look twain could prevent us from curving, but we might draw, like, an black source by that time anyway. So we're gonna start off with Thoughtseize. Have a look at the hand. Oh my god, it's fucking rogues. Wow. So, okay. It will be Nighthawk Scavenger here. Let me have a look. Because Steve Skilled Enforcer is nice to hit with a Fatal Push, especially if you know they have Negate. Card could also be hit by Harvester. Negate could also be a problem eventually. It doesn't have to be. So, like, I have push for... I mean, I guess Harvester hits Enforcer, and I could have push for Scavenger. So maybe Negate is the play. Because I do have cards like Deadly Dispute, I have cards like Ovens, I do have Fables. I think I'll grab Negate. Actually, I've changed my mind. Alright, let's play Harvester out. I love rogues, like, I love that deck so much. I'm shocked to still see someone play it, is all. Alright, my two Kiki's milled, we hate to see it. Yo, G-Dai, thank you so much for the 3 months, appreciate you. Yeah, so that's also something that we can get rid of with the Fable, but obviously, like, we kind of just want to prioritize removing this shit right now, in case they have another rogue to flesh in, which they do. But it should still be in reach, so that's good. This is Fatal pushable right now. This is a 5-3, so that's a pretty big problem. The Harvester can hit that, though. So, I'm just gonna put Harvester in play. We're just gonna do Castle. Okay. Nighthawk Scavenger. They're gonna put us to 8 now, which is a lucky number for them. We do have Crooksass. So let's have a look here. It's going to be remove Nighthawk Scavenger to start with. I will probably then do a Deadly Dispute right now. Let's have a look if we can find a land, maybe. We do. Alright, so let's get a little aggressive with it. Let's put Harvester in play and remove Soaring Thought Thief. There we go. Just gonna try to like minimize the amount of damage they do, right? And next turn we're just gonna like escape Kroxa. The Dross combo, that is fire. Alright, so a lot of their deck revolves around like obviously me having a graveyard. So I'm gonna start by denying that by escaping Kroxa. Does this matter? I don't really think so. So now we're at 5 in the grave rather than 8. But obviously like 8 is the number they want to be at most of the time. So there's a card in the hand. This is upon entering the battlefield, mills 2 cards, so we're not risking trading. It's a new Thought Thief that puts 2 in there. Still got my push. We're going to just start with a swing. Alright, let's try. Oops, I drowned. I think I'm just gonna swing here and just do a new Kroxa. Just keep them off stuff and like threaten lethal on their end. I don't know, I guess rogues nowadays plays like Shelly sometimes, doesn't it? I think. This banger. Alright, let's start off with a swing. Rooksack gets answered again. Okay. I mean, I don't see myself losing from this position, but okay. Let's see what they do, huh? 1 damage to fuel Kroxa. Okay. That works. Right, so this is super reactive. I quite like that. It's a high chance of them milling a cat for us anyway. They start off with a swamp, so we might see that one drop rogue here. So, I mean, I could hold for push, but I think you're better off just playing Oven Out. Because, we don't want to have that countered. Now rogues. Okay. I should say rogues has a should be having in the sideboard. What is that mill card, or the exile card? All right. So let's grab Thought Thief. Swing. It's like, where's Lura's Companion? Second. Now we're gonna just push the Thief's Guild Enforcer, I think, as well. Yeah, they should have Cling the Dust and stuff, but now that I have a food here, I'm okay. I'll try to work my way around it when they eventually mill. Yeah. Okay, so there goes my claim. Holding up. Let's go to the next phase. I'll try to play Devil. I wouldn't get surprised if it gets hit by Drown. Yeah, but it could also just get removed that way, so you know. Yeah, that's a big boy. Alright, let's go in full control. So we can sack Crooks up. Yeah, this is gonna sting a little bit, but and this is based on card types, so we're gonna have to be careful about that one when we escape Ruxa. Take 7, the heal for 7. And let's eat a food then with our remaining mana. Let's not even hesitate to bring this Ruxa out. Card types. So we're definitely hitting the enchantment, we're definitely hitting the artifacts. Getting the land. And let's have a look then. What else do we have? We have 2 instants. But I think we're better off going after sorceries because we have less sorceries in general. No, because there's still Thoughtseize in there. So we're going to do push and dispute. Perfect. 7-3 is huge. 3-3 is a lot more manageable. Fairy Mastermind gets flashed in, and Crooks I gets pushed. Alright. So we're gonna do that again. Medium boy, and that's true. Let's play out our Blood Crypt here then. Yeah, we'll see. I mean, we're gonna take 5. Link Rook's Eye again. Just get rid of the whole graveyard here. And we'll just, layouts, then we're just gonna have to patiently wait on them to like mill a cat and then we're fine. It would help. But Crooks is kind of like the rogue skiller, right? We have a lot of food anyway. Needle? So needle on oven, I imagine. But that's okay. Or it could be on Den as well. That's not a bad play either. Den of the Bugbear. Alright, I think that's valid. And we draw Hive of the Eye Tyrant. Alright, word. Alright, swing then. What's up? Hitting for an insane 9 points of damage. Thanks, girl boss. And pass our turn. You miss Uro, go play Timeless. Mastermind swings in for two. Let's eat two foods here. Alright, so we have ourselves a Harvester. Can discard my Blood Grip still. We just swing the Hive. So we get our Hive drowned, and response probably. Actually, I'm gonna let that go through. I don't know if there's any like exile removal spells. They definitely could though. Anyway, let's play Harvester out. Because then Harvester can remove Fairy Mastermind. And we're gonna remove Mastermind before we pop the blood tokens, if at all. Why not Grooksa swing? I don't wanna risk her getting exiled. She's worth a lot. So like, in rather than like trading and giving them an opportunity to cling her, I can be patient and wait on any of my 100 removal spells, basically. And that's kind of what I'm going for here. Which we hit. So we're gonna be hitting the Scavenger. It's just for the blood. Yep. Swing, big swing. My den is, hitting these on den before someone screams we miss lethal. Got a cat. Anyway.